Hello, my soccer universe. Well, the black Milan shirt kind of says it all. I'm worried about Serie A. COVID is taking over. I'm worried about many games. And we have a derby coming up. Of course, I want Milan to win. But will it be played? But before that, let's talk about the biggest news coming out. Because now, the Juve-Napoli game has been awarded 3-0 to Juve, which kind of was already expected, but they also handed Napoli a 1-point deduction in the standings. My initial reaction, you can see it in the final Serie A video that I did before the international break, was, yeah, I don't understand Juve. I blame Juve as much as everyone else or Serie A. I come a little bit, into more neutral position because Serie A has a protocol and seemingly Napoli did not follow this to a T. And then the local authorities took over. And I also see that there's not much with both Juve and Napoli still playing international. There's not much time to make games up, which gets me again to the point, why are we playing 20 team leagues in COVID times? Why do we play the Champions League, all fixtures? Wouldn't it be, for once, we can have a full Champions League, but make it like tournament style and just play one leg in the group stage? And do that for the whole thing, but I know this is what's talking, and a kind of short-sightedness. I think we will see now a lot of COVID infections all around. We see it already in Serie A happening, and it will happen in other leagues as well. We'll talk about. I'm gonna make a little preview videos after the international break for all the four sections that I'm talking about. So. Short-sightedness. I don't know now, and if you know, please drop below, if Serie A has a contingency plan, if something needs to be cancelled, will they count a championship if there, let's say, are 19 fixtures played? That would be interesting too. I personally think that the 3-0 for Juve, I'm kind of okay with. Now, sure, I would like to see the game played, but given the tight schedule, okay. Hand you the win. I'm not okay with the 1-point deduction. Well, to be honest, I guess what the verdict is, they were seeing an appeals process coming up, and so I think they wanted to kind of punish Napoli a little bit too heavy up front, because in the appeals process, the punishment probably will get reduced, and you still want to get Napoli punished. I think this is what this says to me. It's not a fair verdict. I'm not in any way supporting that. I am not even sure if it should be. Well, there should be a punishment beyond the 3-0 award for Juventus, which to me also seems a little bit harsh. But again, if Napoli really did not follow the protocol, then all right. Then I think I can see Juve's hand in that. The points deduction has an impact on the table now, because Napoli, of course, falls down, has now 5 points even behind Benevento and Hellas, and Juve finds them now in fourth place. It's actually funny that the only teams that were affected were Juve, Inter, and Napoli, but it's down to the points deduction for Napoli. Does make me happy. By the way, the goal average, I took out the three goals for Hellas win over Roma, and now for Juve, so there are 6 goals less. That's why the goal average is maybe a little bit less than what you see goals scored here. But I think it's way too strict. The 3-0, okay, the points deduction will come through. Napoli, of course, will go in an appeals process, so let's see where this will end up. Maybe knowing how Italian processes usually go, it may take a long time, and maybe in the new year we know a little bit more about how Napoli, Juve will end up with the points. I understand that if you have the game replayed, this sets a dangerous precedent that I think everyone would like to avoid. And now for the upcoming fixtures. I mean, we have Napoli, Atalanta and Inter Milan, two wonderful games to start. to start the return with. I mean, Napoli, Atalanta is actually not that COVID affected. We still have Elmas and Zielinski. The two are out. And, you know, there is, I think, one guy for Atalanta so far. So, yeah, that game, I think, will go ahead. But the big one is, of course, Inter Milan, the derby, where Inter has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 players missing due to COVID. Bastoni, Gagliardini, Nainggolan, Radu, Skriniar, and Ashley Young. And two for Milan, Duarte and Gabbia. Duarte probably is not a big one, but Gabbia has been playing in the defense. Romagnoli is suspected to come back. So let's see about that. I also see Rebic is not playing, but who is playing? Zlatan is playing. So might be interesting. I still would favor Inter quite some, to be honest, even with the injuries. But hey, Milan hasn't conceded a goal yet. So slight hope, but my expectation is Inter to win it. And I really hope they're not winning it like last time when Milan get the expectations for me high at halftime and then my hopes came crashing down. Anyway, in addition to the derby, we also have, of course, the Cristiano Ronaldo case where, yeah, he's now down with COVID and with all the squad travelings and, you know, for international duty, I think some more players will have contracted COVID. And, you know, if Ronaldo is now not with the squad training and so on, I am honestly, Juventus could also have some outbreak. We already have Genoa, as I said, who plays probably the youth team squad at the moment. So no fun times. Anyway, lots of exciting stuff in Serie A. But as I said, COVID is overshadowing it all and I'm worried, to be honest. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Drop a comment below what you think Serie A should do or is doing, if there are any regulations or points that I'm missing at the moment. And yeah, let me know what you'll be watching. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and clicking the little bell icon so that you get an update whenever something happens in my soccer universe. And with that, wish you a wonderful day. Bye!